Breaking news for Apple Watch users. Your Apple Watch will soon be able to do so much more with the new WatchOS 11 update. After using it for over a week, I'm excited to share 12 big new features you'll love. First up, the new Vitals app gives you a comprehensive dashboard of your health metrics, like heart rate and sleep, all in one place. It's a significant improvement over the previous need to check individual apps or the health app on your iPhone. Although it's still basic, adding an overall health or recovery score would make it even better. Another exciting feature is automatic smart stacks, which adapt widgets and live activities based on your daily activities, like tracking food deliveries or weather updates. The Siri Watch Face has been integrated into this system, and for the first time, there are no new watch faces, except for an updated photos face that suggests great photos from your library. You can still choose your own photos from the Apple Watch app on your iPhone, and the new face will automatically find great photos and suggest them as watch faces, giving you multiple options for how the clock appears. WatchOS 11 also brings automatic map tracking, sleep tracking without needing sleep mode, and the ability to pause your activity rings to maintain streaks even if you miss a day. You can also set different ring goals for each day of the week and customize the summary page on the activity app extensively. The Workouts app now includes distance and route maps for more activities, including rowing, and custom workout plans for pool swims, allowing you to add recovery breaks. The training load feature tracks your workout effort and provides a weekly summary to help you manage your fitness levels, although it's not as detailed as some competitors. Other big updates include the check-in feature, which notifies contacts when you reach specific locations, and a translate app that works directly on your Apple Watch. The update improves the double tap feature on the Apple Watch Series 9 and Ultra 2, making it easier to scroll through apps when your other hand is full. Women can now track pregnancy duration in the cycle tracking app, which will factor into overall health graphs, and walking steadiness in later stages of pregnancy will be monitored to reduce the risk of falls. However, there are two important things to note before updating to WatchOS 11 in September. First, you'll need an Apple Watch Series 6 or newer, a second-gen Apple Watch SE, or any of the Apple Watch Ultra models. Second, the battery life might take a hit with the first beta, as is common, but this should improve by the time WatchOS 11 is officially released. So, what do you think? Will you be upgrading to WatchOS 11, or will you stick with WatchOS 10? Let me know in the comments below. And stay tuned for our upcoming video on the Apple Watch X leaks. There are just tons of updates to talk about. This is TechInShows signing out. Cheers.